Welcome to our biology class. Our lesson name, food through digestive tract. In last class, we study about different nutrients and digestive system. Today, we study the topic, food inside mouth. Digestive system, we study different organs. Mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. First we study about the food inside the mouth. What changes happen to food inside the mouth?
Food is masticated and converted into smaller particles. Then it mixes with saliva. These are the main two functions of food inside the mouth. First one, food is masticated and converted into smaller particles. Then it mixes with saliva. The structure and arrangement of teeth is suitable to masticate the food we eat. How many different kinds of teeth are there in the man? Which are they? Mainly four types of teeth are present. Which are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Which is the four type of teeth? Incisors, canines, premolars and molars. These are the four different kinds of teeth in humans. Dental formula is the expression of the number of the teeth of each kind in one half of the upper and lower jaw. What is a dental formula? It is the expression of the number of teeth of each kind in one half of the upper and lower jaw. In human beings, a pair of jaws are present, one upper jaw and a lower jaw. This upper and lower jaw, each half contain these four types of teeth. According to this number of teeth, we make a formula, that is the dental formula. In humans, the permanent dentition consists of 32 teeth in total. With the dental formula, 2, 1, 2, 3, bar. 2, 1, 2, 3, including 2 incisors, 1 canine, 2 premolars and 3 molars in each quadrant. This diagram represents one quadrant. This is the half portion of one jaw. In this dental formula, this 2, it indicates the 2 incisors. Then this one indicates the canine, only one canine in one quadrant. Then this two indicates the premolars, two premolars. Then this last three indicates the molars. If we multiply this formula with 4, we get 32. This total is the 8, 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal 8, is 8 into 4, 32. Total number of teeth in humans is 32. Actually, in childhood stage only 20 teeth is present. That teeth is called milk teeth or temporary teeth. In a particular age, this teeth is replaced to form the permanent teeth. In adult humans, this total number of teeth is 32. Okay, then what is the functions of this different type of teeth? If we take different type of food items, these all food items we take in the same manner? No, if we take vegetables or chicken or rice. These all food items we take in the same pattern? No. If we take a fruit, example carrot, that we bite with our front teeth. That is incisors. So what is the function of incisors? Incisors helps to bite and cut the food. What is the function of incisor? It helps to bite and cut the food. Then, if we cut a chicken piece, we not bite the chicken piece, that we tear. We tear the chicken piece, that will help with the help of canines. Then look this picture, what is the shape of this canine teeth? In the canine teeth, its ends are the very pointed ends. These pointed ends helps to tear the food. In case of carnivorous animals, this canine teeth is well developed. If you listen the teeth of dog or cat, their canine teeth is very large. It helps to tear the food. So what is the function of canine teeth? It helps to tear the food. In case of incisors, we look the teeth. Its ends are very sharp and plain and sharp, and it helps to bite and cut the food. Okay, then premolars and molars. These premolars and molars helps to grinding the food. Premolars helps in chewing the food. If we take rice, how we take rice? We take rice with chewing. It helps in chewing the food. Premolars helps to chewing the food. Then molar helps to grind the food. These are the different functions of different type of teeth. First one, incisor. Incisor helps to bite and cut the food. Canine helps to tear the food. Premolar, it helps in chewing the food. And molar, it helps to grind the food. Next, we look at the structure of a molar teeth. A tooth consists of enamel, dentin, pulp and cementum. A portion of the tooth exposed to the oral cavity is known as the dental crown. This portion is called dental crown. A portion of a tooth exposed to the oral cavity is known as crown, and the portion below the dental crown, this region is known as root. This region is the tooth root. The region between the crown and root is known as neck. This is a narrow region. The region between the crown and a root is called neck. Then, first we say about the structure, enamel. It is the white in color, hardest part and dead tissue. This is the enamel. The outer portion of our teeth is called enamel. It's appeared in white color. If we look at teeth, our teeth is a white color. This white color, what is the reason? That is the reason of enamel. Enamel, it is the white in color. When it is the hardest part in our body, this enamel is the hardest part of our body, then it is built with dead tissue. That is the features of enamel. What is the main features of enamel? It is white in color, hardest part of the body, and it built with the dead tissues. Then just below the enamel we can see another part. This part is called dentin. This region is called dentin. It is a living tissue which forms the tooth. It is the living region. This dentin is the living tissue which forms the tooth. This enamel is the dead tissue, but this dentin is the living tissue which forms the tooth. Inside the tooth, we can see a cavity. That cavity is called pulp cavity. This pulp cavity contains pulp. It is the soft connective tissue in the pulp cavity. Pulp is the soft connective tissue in the pulp cavity. This region is the pulp cavity. It contains the soft connective tissue. This region contains the soft connective tissue. It contains blood vessels, lymph ducts, and nerve fibers. This region contains blood vessels, nerve fibers, and lymph ducts. Next region is the cementum. This region is the joining region. Cementum is built with calcium containing connective tissue. This region is built with calcium containing connective tissue. It holds the tooth in the socket of the gum. It holds the tooth in the socket of the gum. It helps to fix the teeth in its socket. These are the main parts of a tooth. This diagram shows the structure of canine teeth. This is the structure of molar teeth. This is the structure of molar teeth. In this canine structure, this crown portion, this region is a pointed region. But in the molar teeth, this region is the flat region. Then, in there only one root. In the molar teeth, only two roots are present. This only difference between these two teeth. Its internal structure, all parts are the same. Enamel, dentin, pulp, and cementum. These all parts are the same in its internal structure. Then, this canine teeth, it is divided into three regions, crown, neck, and root. This molar teeth are divided into three regions, crown, neck, and a root. Actually, its structure is similar, but its shape only varying. The shapes of, variation of its shapes helps to different function. Okay? Then, in our mouth, which organ helps to digestion? Yes, that is the tongue. The tongue helps tooth to masticate food materials and mix them with saliva. The taste buds in the tongue helps in the sensation of taste. Mainly four different types of taste buds are present in our tongue. That is sweet, sour, bitter, and salty. A fifth taste bud is also present. Its name is umami. This umami is a strong, meaty taste imparted by the glutamate and certain other amino acids. Examples are the taste of seaweeds and mushrooms. The tongue and tooth helps in mastication and moving food into the food bite. What is the main functions of tongue? The tongue helps the tooth to masticate the food material. Then it helps to mix the food with the saliva. Then taste buds in the tongue helps to sensation of taste. Then it helps to move in the food into the food pipe. These are the main functions of tongue. Okay? Our next topic, that is the saliva and digestion. Saliva plays a major role in the process of digestion. The digestive function of saliva include moistening food and helps to create a food bolus so it can be swallowed easily. There are three pairs of salivary glands in our mouth. The major salivary glands are the parotid gland, submaxillary gland and sublingual glands. These are the three pairs of salivary glands in our mouth. Parotid gland, submandibular gland and a sublingual gland. Then this parotid gland, it is located in front and beneath the ear. This is the parotid gland. Its location in front of the located in front and beneath the ear. Next one is the submandibular gland. This is the submandibular gland. It is just under the deep to the jaw, towards the back of the mouth. This is the submandibular gland. Its position just under and deep to the jaw, towards the back of the mouth. Then third one is the sublingual gland. It is located beneath the tongue. These are the main three salivary glands in our mouth. Then the saliva secreted from the salivary glands contains mucus and enzymes like salivary amylase and lysozyme. Saliva is secreted from the salivary gland. The salivary gland contains, the saliva contains mucus and enzymes like salivary amylase and lysozyme. Which is the components of saliva? Salivary amylase, lysozyme and mucus. Then, what is the function of saliva? Saliva contains mucus. It makes the food slimy so that we can swallow. Mucus makes the food slimy so that we can swallow. Next one is the lysozyme. It destroys the disease-causing germs that enter the mouth through our food. Lysozyme that destroys the disease-causing germs that enter the body through our food. Then salivary amylase, it converts starch partially into maltose. This maltose is a form of sugar. Salivary amylase converts starch partially into maltose. Maltose is a form of sugar. Okay. What is the main functions of saliva? Saliva contains mucus, lysozyme and salivary amylase. Then mucus, it makes the food slimy so that it can be swallowed easily. Then lysozyme destroys the disease-causing germs that enter the body through the food. And salivary amylase converts starch partially into maltose and it convert in the form of a sugar. Next one, a experiment. Put some cooked rice in your mouth and chew it for a while. What do you feel after 4 minutes? 4 or 5 minutes, what happened? After some times, we feel a sweet taste. What is the reason? In the mouth, the cooked rice gets mixed with the saliva. It contains the enzyme salivary amylase. It gets mixed with the starch and converts partially into the sugar, that is the maltose. That sugar is the maltose. The sugar is the reason for sweet taste. What is the reason of this sweet taste? First we study the reason of salivary amylase. The salivary amylase is present in our saliva. This salivary amylase converts the starch partially into the maltose. This rice contains starch. Rice contains starch. This starch converted into in the form of maltose. What is the reason of sweet taste, or what is the chemistry behind this? That is, this rice mixed with the saliva, it contains the enzyme salivary amylase. It mixed the starch and convert partially into the sugar in the form sugar. That sugar is the maltose. The sugar is the reason for the sweet taste. Okay, you can understand this topic. Thank you.